Over 250 descendants have come to Samoa for the Coe family reunion, travelling from Canada, Australia, Tonga, American Samoa and New Zealand. Among them are 20 members of the Hutchin family from Christchurch. Today's program includes a trip to the island of Manono. Here they have a Tongan connection. It's a 20-minute boat ride from the mainland of Ubonu. On Manono, no cars, scooters, bikes or dogs are allowed. The pace of life on Manono today is much the same as life on the island was in the 1850s, when Jonas Coe's last wife, Litia, was born. Litia was the daughter of one of the first Tongan missionaries to Samoa, Kawa Moilolo o Panepasa Ahongalu. Ahongalu arrived in Samoa in 1869 and lived here for 40 years.
We are walking in his footprints. He did this walk, and now we are walking it more than 100 years ago. It's very meaningful. Yeah. Our bones are here, and our people need to come here. They never even knew he was here.
It's been a passion for Lossa to get the rest of her whānau to the reunion to reconnect with their history. This Manono trip is one she'd already taken.
Probably the first time one of us has stepped back over 100 years on this island, which is really meaningful. So now we have brought everyone back so they know where he is. This is just a little beginning for us. We need to tie up the loose ends, and that's what we're doing with our Jonas Coe reunion, is tying up those loose ends. And this is what we want to do, is do this, share it, bring them here, let them feel it. And you know what? When they go home, they will carry the story on and everyone will know where they come from.
Back on the mainland of Upolu, it's time for the Coe family to enjoy the culture at Samoa's annual Te Wila Festival. The trip to Samoa is a journey which has come full circle for the family of Max Utridge. His great-grandmother left Samoa 130 years ago.
I'm very proud. I'm a child of the South Seas, and the integral part of that is being a child of Samoa. It may not be a large percentage of our bloodline, but it's a really, really important one. You know, it's been a real awakening. It's probably been even more deeply moving and emotional than I expected it to be.
Max and some of his siblings were born in Papua New Guinea after their great-grandmother and many of her extended family moved there from Samoa in the late 1800s. The influence of the extended Coe family on Papua New Guinea is still felt there today, including some Samoan influence on the language.
Well, when the Coe family came to PNG, Tok Pisin was being formed at the time, the national language of PNG, and it was contributed to by various, by English, German, and now we know Samoan. There's a number of words we've just been finding out in the short time we've been here. We had the umu, and then the New Guineans adapted that to mumu. Lava lava, they adapted it to lap lap. There's a direct word, susu, for milk, is used in both societies and both cultures and both languages.
It's the final day of the Coe family reunion, and descendants gather to share stories, photos, and make connections.
Anna Marie, this is Laura.
Hello. Hello. So nice to meet you.
Yes, I'm back. I have learned a lot from the last 4 days, sharing stories with direct descendants of my ancestors. I'm very proud of what they have done.
The reunion has been very interesting. It's been fantastic meeting all our cousins and relations, the different line. I am very proud of my links to Samoa. I think it's not every day everybody has a connection to an island, to a community in an island in the South Pacific. How lucky can you be?
I think it's incredibly important just to know where you come from is you can't put a value on it, really. And just being in touch and knowing who all your family or your ainga are. And I think that's incredibly important for all the generations into the future.
There's something about this culture and this nation and that family that has strong women, and they're the ones, the women who really, really led and nourished and kept these families going.
Family is really important, you know, and it's the ties of family that they call me the matriarch at home. I think I might change it to Maliatoa, actually. Now something's a much nicer word.
We never knew how many cousins we have, Palangi ones, you know, because we were brought up in Samoa.
Oh, I'm so proud of being one of the Palangi guys.
After 4 days together, the Coe descendants must now say goodbye. They came as strangers. They leave as family.
I've never felt so much love. These are people that we've met a week ago, but we know in our hearts that we're all one. And there's just that bond that's, you can't fake it. We'll get together real soon. And yeah, it's the start of something real big.
I am a Coe. I love being a Coe. I'm proud to be a Coe. Family is everything. Family is the beginning and the end, and yep, it's everything.
You love these people
you've met. Absolutely. I've never met them before, but they're part of us. You know, they're part of us, and you look out here, this is us. We come from here. I love them all, and they're my cousins. And it's wonderful now. We meet each other and we say, "Hi, cousin." It's wonderful.